Well, this is an exciting time in the history of our college. We're just getting ready to embark with the opening of a new veterinary diagnostic lab building here at the Iowa State University campus. It's the officially recognized veterinary diagnostic lab, and in Iowa, we're the only fully accredited in what they call a full-service diagnostic laboratory, meaning we provide a comprehensive veterinary diagnostic service, with the primary service being provided to veterinary practitioners in Iowa and across the country. The Veterinary Diagnostic Lab here at Iowa State is the largest food animal center diagnostic lab in the U.S. and actually in North America, if not the world. And so Iowa is a tremendous importer of animals to be grown, fed, milked, and so on, and a tremendous export of food products throughout the country and throughout the world. And the role that agriculture plays in Iowa is highly significant, and that with that being our principal focus, there's just an awful lot of connectivity with our clientele, both within Iowa and then with entities that are moving a lot of animals into Iowa, again, for further growing and breeding. The current facilities that we're in today, in short, have outgrown those. The existing facilities, as it relates to today's standards for biosecurity, biocontainment, and biosafety, are actually quite outdated. And so we needed to proceed forward with essentially building, it's essentially a 50-year upgrade to take today's standards as we move forward. But it's very much built for purpose. It's built for a lot of flexibility going forward, and it's built to today's standards. And we think it'll also be a tremendous facility that is going to be used for not only its practical purposes for the services being provided, the use of that service material to help drive our teaching and applied research missions, but also as a means of helping telling the story concerning Iowa and U.S. animal agriculture. We receive something just north of 120,000 case submissions each year. That's somebody somewhere with some animals on a farm or their pet, or even some wildlife, that has a need to submit samples for a clinical diagnostic workup. And so we receive those samples, and then we use that flow of case material as a very real world means for teaching the next generation of veterinarians and future diagnosticians, because we're kind of ground zero for all this material coming in. And again, that flow of diagnostic material and those workups are used very much for hands-on education for the veterinary students, as well as for diagnosticians that are being further trained. It's really state-of-the-art instrumentation that is being used day in, day out to deliver quality, assured, and rapid diagnostic results to stakeholders, again, in Iowa and throughout the country. And so the students are very much exposed to such technologies, so the learning about what those technologies are and then how they can utilize the laboratory and such technologies as they move on in their professional career. The building we're in, phase one, essentially just thinking about the front half of the laboratory, it's actually where everything is received. It's the most bio-insecure type things with necropsy floor, things like this. But the most of the higher end analytical testing is in phase two. We're looking forward to the grand opening for phase one, which is gonna occur on April 4th of this year, and the groundbreaking for phase two, which is essentially would finish the entirety of the project, will be the groundbreaking for phase two again on that same ceremony on April 4th. The support from the legislature and from all of the Iowa Veterinary Medical Association, all of the commodity groups in Iowa were each extremely supportive to move this project forward, because it's very much a significant economic infrastructure investment for our state of Iowa. And so we're honored to be a part of that.